Part 11 in our optics series is about something. Well, I can't really remember, so I guess we'll just kind of riff on something for a little while. Since there's all this wet stuff falling from the sky, I guess we can talk about waterproofing. Waterproofing, as it turns out, is really important no matter where you live. At some point, you are going to get your scope wet, even if it's with the tears that you cry when you miss that 10-point buck. But really, you never know when a thunderstorm is going to pop up. You never know when you're going to trip and throw one of these into a puddle or something. If you're actually out in the real world doing real work, and even if you're just on a real range that's outdoors, you are going to encounter water at some point. Now, pretty much all scopes nowadays are going to have some kind of waterproof listing on them. Everybody's going to say that their stuff is waterproof, and there are different levels. I'm going to put a chart here. This is the IP ratings. This is an indication of an actual kind of outside organization standard of waterproofing, and this applies to all kinds of things. So this could be enclosures, it could be electronics, it could be scopes. And when you're dealing with waterproofing, it's going to be IP, and then you're going to have X. X is the how it deals with dust and debris. And if there is some kind of rating for how it deals with dust and debris, instead of an X, it'll have a number. But the one that we're looking at is the number on the far right. It's going to be 0 through 8, and who knows what other kinds of things they'll be throwing in there. There might be some new standards at some point. But yeah, it's going to go from either not tested, IPXX, IPX0, doesn't handle water at all, don't get this wet, and then all the way down to IPX8, which is going to be go ahead and throw it into the shallow end of the pool and leave it there for who knows how long and pull it up later, everything's going to be fine. Now these kind of standards are going to apply to some scopes. I imagine that it's an expensive proposition to actually take a scope and get it tested by one of these international groups to see how it actually functions. So you're not going to see it all that often. You're going to see it some. And that's one of the reasons why I kind of harp on Bushnell. Bushnell apparently has tested a whole lot of their scopes out in real world conditions and in these labs as well. They've actually sent a bunch of these off. And so we actually have IPX7 ratings on, I think, pretty much all of their scopes from the Prime on up. So that's the Prime, Engage, Nitro, Forge, up through Elite Tactical. These can handle a lot of water. And IPX7 means that I can throw this, again, into that shallow end of the pool for up to 30 minutes. And these, as I have tested out in the real world, yeah, they can handle it. I haven't thrown them in the water or anything, but they sure can handle rain and nothing happens to them. So yeah, if you are wanting to pick up a scope that you absolutely know is going to have some kind of waterproofing to it, go check out Bushnell's catalog. But then some of the others, they're going to have their own listings, like the Falcon that I just keep harping on. My buddies and I have done all kinds of terrible things to this scope, and we have not damaged it. It actually has some little scratches in the finish, has some chips where we've dropped it. This has been thrown into mud, it's been thrown into water. I've had this out in just deluge conditions, and there is no problem with this whatsoever. On their own website, they say that this can handle what is it? Yeah, I think it's 1 meter of water, or is it 3 meters of water? Anyway, it can handle some water. It doesn't say for how long, but yeah, this can deal with all kinds of nasty conditions as I have tested. So yeah, if your scope doesn't have any kind of IP rating or any indication of how it deals with water, for how long, at what depth, then you can check out the independent scope reviewers. You're going to be hearing from a lot of folks like the people down in the description below, some of my favorite optics reviewers. They will have actually gone out and tested a lot of these, and they can let you know if they actually stood up to wet weather or, you know, puddles the way that the company has stated on their website. Now that's kind of a tough one. A lot of people test gear in, you know, nice conditions, so you may not hear everything that you want about every scope you like, but just know that somewhere the truth is out there, and hopefully you can be able to find it. In my own reviews, I'll let you know if I got a scope wet and how it dealt with the water. for the most part, I have been seeing a lot of good results from a lot of these scopes, even some on the lesser expensive side. The Simmons have held up to water just fine. They seem to have their O-rings in the right place, so if it rains, even if it's a deluge, I haven't had problems so far. So I think we have a lot of really good manufacturers right now that are trying to make sure that things are waterproofed. Just keep your ears open if you hear of maybe a lesser known company, you know, just see if there's some information out there. That's it for today about waterproofing. It's kind of the Wild West when it comes to that, so good luck finding out what's actually out there. Don't miss the next videos in the series. Make sure you hit that notification bell and subscribe so you don't miss anything that's coming up. We're gonna get into some really interesting topics, like one that will allow you to kind of figure out the qualities of your scope before you even leave your sporting goods store. If you can look through it and check out a couple things, you might be able to figure out the actual qualities of your scope and leave with something that hopefully is going to work out really well for you. So yeah, don't miss a thing. Thanks to patrons of the Destructive Arts for making videos like these possible. They provide a lot of the gear and cameras and audio and lighting and all that sort of stuff. You guys rock. So at the 338 Lapua Magnum level, we have these guys. And at the 300 Win Mag level, we have these guys. Thanks a lot, y'all, and I will see you in the next video. Oh, I remember what we were going to talk about.
Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So, you can become a patron of the Destructive Arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.